Australian junior titles, it's a great thing. That's good to see what's happening in junior motocross right now, and the Australian titles is where it all presents, and it's good to get back to the grassroots and basically have a look and see where the sport's heading at this level. All the dads around and working flat out on bikes just reminds me of when I was in my junior career, and yeah, there was like likes of McFarlane's and Hardman's, Marmont's, doing the same sort of thing, and you know, it's where we all started.
I was one of these kids once upon a time, and racing a bike for 26 years now, and you know, been to many races. So the best advice to give a kid is the most honest advice. They're all here for a reason. They all know they're capable to race in an Australian title race. So it's more just to help them out within themselves, just helping them out their headspace and whatever results they're getting, and you know, do what they you know do best, which is love riding a motorbike.
There's some fast kids, and just walking around seeing the setups, all the teams and that, it's looking pretty good. It's obviously changed a lot since when I was junior. There's a huge opportunity there for the young fellows on KTM. You're basically getting a factory ride here, and the support's amazing from them.
There's some really, really, really quick kids coming through the packs. I just think they look really strong. Their bike skills are really, really good. There's a lot of depth in the class. Everyone's battling, and some of the juniors that are coming up the senior next year will be a real threat, I think.
Whereas the Australian Junior Championships support all of our customers, it has been known other years for us to rebuild engines here at the track, keeping people in the championship and their dreams alive, and that's the reason we're here. I'm all about racing, especially when the sun's shining.
Well, we come to these events because we're supporting this year a bunch of kids and families with the KX Junior squad that we started this year. So we've got about six families with seven kids that we've been doing some support with. This is our way of just showing some support at the biggest event for the nationals, for the juniors for the year. Just seeing how many kids and families are still involved in junior racing coming through, that's pretty important, because some people think there's racing is sort of dying around the country in some areas and it's costing too much, but to see hundreds of kids here racing and parents and the amount of effort, you know, it brings back my good old days when I used to do a bit of racing as a kid as well.
As a parent, we had an awesome weekend. The event was run quite well. It's definitely a good sport to get into.
It's sort of one big family. Like, today we had a drama and so many people just came and went, here's a hand and here's another one and what can I do?
Hi, buddy.
We have just travelled everywhere all over Australia now, and it's just awesome going out with the family. We just want to give the kids the best opportunity and give it a go.
I think it's awesome. If it wasn't for them, none of this would have happened. So yeah, I'm really thankful that they bring us here all the time and support us.
Yeah, four. Come on, mate, go.
It was a really good week. Track was awesome. They did really good to prep it, and there was some really good racing, so it was good fun. Enjoyed racing the fastest kids from, you know, all around and having some really good competition.
From local races to state racing titles to the national events, there's something for everybody out there. And whether you're racing at a highly competitive level or just at a casual level, it's good fun to get on bikes and go racing.
Definitely get out there and give it your best shot. You never know what can happen. Just go out there and have fun and try your hardest and see where it gets you.
Il Renz è nato da una voglia di, intanto che hanno tutti i piloti del mondo, di avere una pista propria. Ci siamo sempre allenati in delle cave, diciamo, che ci siamo fatti prestare, e con delle moto da cross con la ruota dietro meno tassellata per cercare di fare i traversi. E il Renz è l'evoluzione di questo allenamento, quindi una pista di flat track, un ovale come si usa in America. E quindi da lì è nato il Renz, che è diventato senza dubbio il nostro parco giochi, ecco. Nel race di base ci sono 4 piste. Il giro intero è 2,5 km. Si gira in 2 minuti e 10 più o meno, dipende dalle giornate. Allora, c'è l'ovale classico con dentro un ovale più piccolino. Poi c'è la parte del fagiolo, noi la chiamiamo, diciamo. E poi c'è la parte del TT, che è una parte molto differente, un po' più stretta e un po' più lenta anche, che è questa, che si va su qua, si ritorna giù, si ripassa dentro il fagiolo. Poi c'è anche una piccola pista da cross, facile, diciamo, che gira intorno. Sta diventando sempre più affascinante il race, no? Perché tutti i piloti, soprattutto perché tutti i piloti vogliono venire a vedere com'è, a provare, perché è una pista un po' diversa dalle altre, no? E c'è un'atmosfera bellissima, secondo me, perché cioè molto privata. Anche tanti piloti che sono venuti sono potuti stare un giorno in tranquillità, in relax, senza pressione, solo cercando di divertirsi e dare il gas. È una curva doppia, perché per quello che si chiama Rossi Graziano. Perché lui, no, quando parlava di lui, diceva sempre: io sono Rossi Graziano. Allora è una curva lunga, la Rossi Graziano che chiude. E allora, siccome lui è stato sempre il nostro mentore del traverso, il nostro guru del traverso, gli abbiamo dedicato anche una curva. Sì.
Mi chiamo Rossi Graziano. Sono un ex pilota di moto che però si è allenato con le moto da flat track fino al mese scorso con Valentino a Tavuglia, perché io sono il barbo di Valentino e adesso avrei deciso di smettere con le moto perché cado, continuo a cadere ogni tanto e mi faccio sempre del male. E allora vorrei essere solamente un pilota di automobilismo, corro con le automobili da rally e mi piace molto guidare di traverso.
Essere un pilota della MotoGP ed essere ancora uno dei più forti dopo tanti anni è un grande motivo di orgoglio per me. E il bello è proprio quello, che prima di salire in moto, prima di fare la gara, la sensazione, l'adrenalina, quello che provi è esattamente uguale a 20 anni fa, ecco.